I'm sorry. Sorry to break the news for you. You can't get that fat on purpose the healthy way. Coach Greg, and you may know Mark Wahlberg from his famous roles in the Transformers, but did you know he's a real world Transformer?
I made that shit up.
Like, literally transforms his physique from fat to thin, muscular to fat, and so on. He has previously put on 40 pounds of muscle for a role, but for this role, it's the opposite. He plans to gain 40 pounds of fat in 6 weeks. 40 pounds. As you see on the left, he's shredded, full six-pack, looking muscular. And of course, many people sent me the photo saying, talk about his gyno, look at the gyno. I've already done a video on Mark Wahlberg saying that I do not think he's natural. I have never thought he was natural. And if you compare his photo from left to right, you can see just how much fat he's gained. He's obviously doing this for a movie role, but how do you think he's feeling on the inside? Imagine this is your physique. Imagine you're the shredded Mark Wahlberg. You have your dream physique, and you have to let it go away. You have to put on fat on purpose. It may or may not be an enjoyable experience. He may be struggling to stay lean. He might use this as an excuse that finally I can eat something that I want. Finally, I have a reason. I'm getting fat for a movie role. Let me be. Imagine if he gained all this weight and it wasn't for a movie role. What would the videos be saying? What would be the narrative? Guaranteed there would be video after video saying, check out Mark Wahlberg's dad bod. Can you believe it? Look how he let himself go. Meanwhile, maybe he just wanted to stop taking PDs and eat a little bit. Imagine the pressure to look amazing when you already look amazing. I caution people all the time to have realistic goals and expectations. Once you've achieved that elite status, that amazing physique that people love, it's hard to keep it. If you lose your willpower, get injured, or go off the diet, it's not going to last. So he's literally going to have to force feed to gain that much weight. You need 3,500 calories above maintenance to gain 1 pound. If you try to gain 30 pounds in 30 days, you need to eat 3,500 calories more than your maintenance. Day one, you love it. You're eating the chicken nuggets and hot wings that you haven't had in years. But guess what? Sooner or later, you reach your ceiling weight. Your body doesn't want to get any fatter. Ghrelin is gone away. Leptin's in full force saying, stop eating. But you say, no, I need to gain another 20 pounds, and you keep eating. It's uncomfortable. It's arguably just as uncomfortable or more to get fat on purpose when your genetics don't want you to as it is to diet down to your dream physique. I've tried it. I've done it both ways. I've dieted for bodybuilding competitions and literally I've tried to get as fat as I possibly could to try and break a world record in the bench press. Tried to get fatter than last time, ate everything, was never hungry. Wake up middle of the night, puke. Not because I wanted to, because I couldn't keep the food down. It was that uncomfortable. If you have amazing genetics to be lean, it is hard to get fat. It's just as hard for someone who's naturally lean to get fat as it is for someone who's fat to get shredded. Just as hard. Mark Wahlberg, like many of us, is a health nut, a fitness freak. He's training 5 days a week. He values and respects the importance of being healthy. But is this healthy? What could this do to his body? Well, let's go and read some of the comments. Doing it the healthy way and keeping strong with hard workouts. There is no healthy way to put on 30 or 40 pounds of fat in a month or two. You can't do it the healthy way. I'm sorry. Sorry to break the news for you. You can't get that fat on purpose the healthy way. You can keep working out and you can keep doing cardio, but if you get fat on purpose, that is not healthy. It is not healthy. Let me make it clear. Just because you do cardio and lift weights doesn't mean you're healthy. You're healthier than if you didn't, but if you're obese, especially if you're morbidly obese, it's not healthy. There is no such thing as healthy at every weight. Healthy is healthy. You can get healthier by losing weight. You can get healthier by exercising. You can get healthier by lifting weights, by doing cardio. But if you think that you're healthy at 300 pounds because you're lifting weights, you're doing cardio, you're not. You're healthier than if you didn't, but you're not as healthy if you exercised, lifted weights, and got down to 200 pounds. And I'm not saying this to discourage you. I'm just telling you the truth. There is no healthy at any size. So although Mark is doing everything in his power to make this healthy, it's not. Yo-yo dieting is not healthy. It is not healthy to get fat and then get thin and get fat and thin. That's yo-yo dieting. That's what most people do. That is not healthy. You are much better to pick a weight that you can maintain for the rest of your life. Mark would be better off gaining the 20 pounds and maintaining it for the rest of his life than gaining 40 and then losing the 40 back and forth. The yo-yo dieting is not healthy. And what do I personally think is happening? Don't know if it is, but this is what I would do if I was Mark Wahlberg. If I was on TRT or a PD cycle, they wanted me to get fat and play a priest or something out of shape, I'd go off TRT, I'd go off my cycle. Go completely off. I'd lose some muscle, my metabolism would slow down. I would have less nutrient partitioning, would be less building of muscle and more storing of body fat. Mario Lopez says, yo, you wear mad chubby well, homie. Think there's a little bias in that. When you're friends with someone, not likely you're gonna tell them the truth. Oh, you gained 20 pounds in a couple weeks? You look great. You gained 30 pounds? Oh, it's awesome. You look happier now. Do you really? Do you really believe that? If your girlfriend asks you if you look good in those pants and you don't, are you going to say nope? Well, I sure am, but most people are going to lie. And it looks just as hot in person, baby. Oh, isn't that sweet? Do you think she's really going to tell the truth? Oh, you look just as hot in person. Yeah, you gained 40 pounds. You look just as hot in person. Trust me, you're so hot. Maybe, what would you all do if the love of your life gained 40 pounds of fat on purpose in a short period of time, 6 weeks? What would you think? What would you do? Would you say, you look just as amazing as always? Or would you say, you don't look as amazing as always? Literally. I mean, am I lying? Am I wrong? When you're single versus when you're married. I mean, that's the best caption right there. Single, married. Y'all letting yourself go, oh, I'm married now. I don't need to look good. Then you get a divorce and all of a sudden you're joining the gym, getting in shape. Maybe you should stay in shape and do it for your marriage. Just because you're married, you don't think your significant other deserves to have the best quality person that they can be with? I get it. It's what's on the inside that counts. But don't you also want to look good on the outside? Don't you want to show that you can take care of yourself? Is your appearance not important? Do you not owe it to yourself and your partner? I'm asking, don't you think it's important to look good for both your partner and yourself? Do the best. I'm not saying you need to be perfect, but do the best you can do to look and feel the best that you can. Welcome to how the rest of us look post-quarantine. I mean, it's true. During quarantine, so many people have given up in the gym. I've had so many clients call and hire me because, hey, I gained all this weight. I stopped going to the gym. I stopped exercising. Sat on the couch and I forgave myself. I ate whatever I wanted. Went to the pantry, had chips. During the time of the COVID, so many people use the excuse of we can't go out to the gyms, we can't exercise, sat at home depressed, eating chips, getting fatter, getting more depressed. You think it's good for the mind to just say, oh, let's just forgive ourselves right now and eat chips. Let's just stop moving, let's stop exercising. We got an excuse to COVID. Let's worry about it later. Then later comes and you got to lose 50 pounds. Was it worth it? Or should you right now get off your ass, move, go for a walk, go and get some exercise? Don't do it for me. Do it for you. Do it for your partner. Do it for your parents. Do it for your friends, your family, your pets. Do it. Just do it. And I get it. Some of the way he's gaining is not fat. There's going to be a lot of water with this. When you eat a lot of carbs, sodium, you're going to have more glycogen stores. You're going to be bloated, have more water retention. But trust me, it is not healthy. Could affect negatively your blood pressure, cholesterol, and so on. So if you have gained weight on purpose or by accident during this friggin' time at a cove, be careful. It is not healthy. Even if you're exercising, if you gain 30 or 40 pounds of fat, that is going to negatively impact your health. Ending it here. GregDucette.com for coaching. GregDucette IP Pro. The bloops are over there. Watch one of those. Follow me on the gram to talk. Don't forget to hire me or my team for coaching. Get the freaking cookbooks, the training books. Subscribe, click the bell button. And until next time, I am out.
Gertie, man. If you guys saw Gertie jumping in circles right now, it's be... Yeah, anyway. Gertie jumping in circles.